Now, let's discuss saturation. One of the most important things about well-graded footage or cinema, they do not treat saturation as one value. They don't usually increase or reduce the saturation as one parameter. You have to think of saturation as different small adjustments that are done throughout the image. Usually shadows are way less saturated than midtones and highlights. And highlights are usually also a bit less saturated than the midtones. And even controlling which part of the midtones is more saturated is very important. So let's take a look at this image here. Now I'm going to add a new node, come to curves, go to Luma versus saturation, and just take the saturation out of the shadows, okay, and increase it in the midtones. Now notice the more I take it to the left, it looks different. The more I take it to the right, the image looks a bit different. It's very important to understand how do you control your saturation. One of the best tricks I like to do is just to have a new node and just keep it towards the end of the stream. So this is the last node things will pass through. And I will always keep the shadows less saturated in this node. It will be much more clear when you look at this footage. Now color, reset all grades and nodes. Let me just balance this a bit. Okay, let's add a node. I'm going to try to grade this footage like in a strange way. I'm just going to come to primaries and push shadows towards blue. Okay, it's looking a bit better, but this is never professional. For some reason, it just never looks professional. And if you right-click and go to scopes, you will understand why. The difference here in the shadows between the green, blue, and red channel is just strange, you know, that the shadows are way saturated. Usually what I like to do is to keep a nod. I'm going to delete this nod, add a new nod, bring it towards the end here, and just reduce the saturation in the shadows through the Luma versus saturation curve. And increase it back in the midtones here. And now I'm going to keep this node just active in the end, always desaturating the shadows no matter what I do in the nodes before it. So back to this node, add a new node, and now I'm going to try to push blue into the shadows again. Notice how different the effect look. His clothes is always desaturated. Let me just deactivate this node, the one that desaturates shadows, and bring it back on. Look. Look to these sides here, to the edges of the screen. Look how strange this looks and how natural this look. Of course, there is no wrong and right here. This is what I think. But usually what I do, a trick that I like to use, is just to keep this knot towards the end of the knot structure and always make it desaturate the shadows no matter what I do before it.